As a skilled ranger, Faramir has been purging the wilds of Ithilien of the servants of the Dark Lord Sauron. Now he must protect Osgiliath from the forces of evil, or Gondor will fall. In this video, we'll be painting Faramir quickly, only using 10 paints, so you'll be playing in no time at all. Those 10 paints we'll be using are on the screen right now. Remember that these are our recommendations, and you can paint Faramir in any way you want. If you are new to painting or want to know the paints and techniques used in this video, check out the Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos in the description. The first thing we'll be doing is undercoating the model, and for this we've used Grey Sear. This is perfect for the contrast colours we'll be using and the stone he is vaulting over. It's also a good idea to have the base paint pot that matches the spray to hand, just to tidy up any mistakes we make along the way. First, we'll start by applying Garrigax Sewer over the leather tunic, gloves, boots, quiver, arrow, straps and scabbard. Our small base brush is perfect as it's big enough to hold the paint and small enough to get into those hard to reach places. We can also apply some to the smaller rocks and the mud surrounding the stone wall on the base. This will help the scenery tie into any muddy bases, if you are choosing to do so. As this is a contrast paint, we would normally use it quite heavily when applying it, but in this case, we want to apply the paint in lighter coats. This is so we can get those smaller details to stand out more, which will look like we have already highlighted the leather. If you do apply too much though, don't worry. You can remove some by soaking it away with a clean dry brush. Garrigax Sewer doesn't sound very pleasant, but it's the right shade of brown for the light and worn leather of the Rangers of Ithilien. Next, we'll use Black Templar for the black trousers and van braces on his arms. We'll switch over to a small layer brush for these, as it's thinner and will allow us to get under those forearms and avoid getting the black contrast on the brown that we just painted. Just like Garrigax Sewer, we want to apply this in small light layers. As there is such a dark pigment in this paint, it will cover any little mistakes or patches of the brown if it's in the wrong area. If you want to, you can apply a second layer to the straps around his arm to get a solid colour. Just take your time. With both those contrasts fully dry, we can move on to Vulcan Green for the cloak, waist belt and tabard with our small base brush. As this is a layer paint, we will need 2 to 3 coats to get a full solid colour. It might seem strange to use a layer paint as a base coat, but Vulcan Green is the right green for the job. A vibrant yet natural green. Next, we'll apply Zandri Dust to the tunic details, the boot laces and the sleeves under the van braces, and we'll be using our small layer brush for these very small details. We'll take our time though, making sure that our brush has a sharp point. We can do this by rolling the brush on our palette after we have thinned down our paint. This can also help us control how much paint we have on our brush as well. We can also paint the white tree of Gondor in this colour as well, as it's also on the tunic. Just use the side of the brush so we pick out the raised edges, avoiding the leather underneath. You can also use the same simple technique to paint the laces on the boots. Now we'll apply Gilliman Flesh to the skin. By using our small layer brush and a small amount of paint, we can quickly cover his face and neck. Just make sure that we get into the eye sockets gently, as we don't want too much paint pooling in those small details, as we could potentially lose them. We can fix these issues by soaking up the paint with a clean brush, but if we apply less in the future in a controlled way, we will avoid having to fix them. With the skin dry, we can paint his hair, beard and arrow fletchings with Tau Light Ochre. Still using our small layer brush, we can carefully paint over the contrast on the fletchings, as this paint will cover those mistakes. Be careful though when painting his hair and especially his beard, as we're going to be going onto his skin. So take your time and keep that brush pointed. Tau Light Ochre is a yellow colour with a slightly burnt orange tone to it, making it great for the fiery red hair of Faramir. Next we'll move on to the metallics, and we'll start by using Lead Belcher for the sword, the buckles and the details on the van braces. Just take your time finding and painting all these little details, as we have a lot of other colours already applied to our model. If you aren't quite sure where to paint the silver, you can also refer to the box art if you wish. We're trying to be careful not to get any of this paint on the previously painted colours, but we can easily fix that by using grey sear base paint and reapplying the contrasts. Now we'll apply Skullcrusher brass to the sword hilt and metal parts of the scabbard. Just like with Lead Belcher, we want to apply a few thin coats to build up the metallic flakes, giving more shine when the paint is dry. Once you have done your last metallic layer and cleaned off your brush, we'll change our paint water for our last paints, just so we don't get any of those metallic flakes into them. Skullcrusher brass may be a layer paint, but the bright burnished gold tone is perfect for the brass-like gold of the Men of Gondor. With all our major colours dry, we can shade over with Agrax Earthshade. We'll shade pretty much over everything, apart from his skin. We'll get a good amount on our brush and start moving around all those recesses and folds of the green cloth, over both the metallics and over the brown leather and all of the stone he is vaulting over. Be careful on applying it to his hair and the fletchings though, as we don't want to make the shade too dark and dirty. We just want to add a little bit of light shading. So if you apply too much, just soak it up with a clean brush. After our shade is fully dry, we'll add a light dry brush of Screaming Skull over the whole model. We are using a medium dry brush for this, as it gives us a larger surface area over the bristles. So after a few circular dry brushing motions, it will be uniform over the whole model, and only hit those top trace areas with the Screaming Skull paint. This will also give the illusion of a highlight all over. If you want a sharper look, you can also add a second dry brush to the stone wall, just to add a heavier weathered look. We're using Screaming Skull as it's a light colour with a slight amount of warmth, so it's great for skin, hair, leather, and also the green cloth. And there we are! Faramir, the Captain of Gondor, is finished and ready to show his quality. You can see that our model is based in Stirling mud, but you can base it in any colour that you want. And if you'd like to learn more about basing, check out our technical paints video all about it. For more tutorials, tips and techniques, head to citadelcolour.com, or you can also head into a store where our friendly staff can offer you more help. Well, we hope you enjoyed this video and we'll see you next time. Bye bye!